at the Tampa Bay Pro Combine, what are some things that you're trying to showcase in front of executives and just throughout this process in general?
Yeah, I mean, obviously I'm not the biggest guy, strongest guy, fastest guy out here, so the biggest thing is my heart. I'm going to go out there and compete every time, every second that I'm out there on the court, being able to pass the ball well and shoot it well from other people throwing me the ball or whatnot. Receiving ball screens is another big thing, a big key aspect that I focus on and I want to showcase a little bit. So those are just a few things that I focus on to showcase here.
Your dad and your brother also played, you know, D1 schools. How did basketball kind of, did you play a lot with your brother growing up? And how did you guys, how did they help you as you kind of go through this journey since they've kind of been in that position before?
Honestly, I got to give all the credit to them, both of them, especially my dad growing up. He never forced basketball on me or anything like that, but he really just focused on hitting the nail on the head, really, there in high school, and he really focused on making me focused on in the classroom, but also off the court things, and that's one of the biggest things, being a better teammate than even a player, and I think that goes a long way, especially in things like this. But obviously, having both of them playing the Big Ten, my dad playing at Butler as well, definitely really helped me growing up, playing with my older brother, playing one-on-one. We do that now even, so it just makes me better, and they I got to give all the credit to them, really.
So how proud is he, four-time academic All-Big Ten? That's a great mark right there, man. Yeah. I mean, and it shows that you found that balance. And how hard was that, balancing, you know, being an elite athlete at your school and also having to maintain that GPA?
It's definitely tough, and I don't think the outside world really understands how tough and how difficult it really is to juggle practice and being away from normally your home, as I was, and then going to practice games, away games, trips, and schedules is a little different. So it's definitely tough, but it's definitely doable, and you always have all the resources there that you need to accomplish that. And grades has always been a big thing for me and my family. My parents have harped on it since we were in grade school. So it really came kind of easy to me once we got to college because I had been doing it so long my entire life.
Who are some players that you've modeled your game after, or you studied their film or things like that?
Yeah, there's honestly a lot of people. I mean, there's a lot of great guards in the NBA now, but the first person that I think of is my older brother. I like the way he plays, and obviously him living at home and being around me all the time and growing up with him, I've kind of taken a lot of his things and a lot of things that he does. But I honestly like CJ McConnell's game, even a little bit of what Dame and Russell Westbrook from the mid-range game, especially Westbrook's mid-range pull-up is something I've taken and I've tried to master over the years. So those are just a few people that come off the bat that I can think of.
For sure. You're one of the more experienced players going through this process, you know, 25 years old. We see a lot of times with the draft, teams are obsessed with potential, and you know, we 19, 20-year-old kids. What are some of the advantages of being an older player that's been through a lot and seen a lot at the college level?
Yeah, I think, honestly, I'm going to use that to my advantage, and that's what I'm going to sell, that I'm already mature. I'm mature enough to go out there, and you don't have to mold me into somebody. I know I can fit into any role that they ask me to play, and I can go out there and lead if you need me to. I can be an assist guy. I can be a shooter if you need me to. So there's a lot of advantages to not being that 18, 19-year-old that they're going to be drafting in the draft. So that's what I'm really selling, is I'm a mature 25-year-old, a mature point guard that has been through everything. So I've been in every setting.
Are there any misconceptions about you or your game that you're hoping to disprove throughout this process?
Yeah, I want to say my finishing ability and then my passing ability is definitely two things that I really want to focus on and be able to showcase. I think that so far in this combine that I've done pretty well in the shooting mid-range and shooting from three, but I want to be able to showcase a little bit more that other teams might not know about me.
And then what are some things you like to do off the court, away from basketball, when you're not hooping? What do you like to do?
When I'm back home, I'm always hanging out with my family or friends, and a few things that we like to do is top golf. Mm-hmm. We went to Main Event here, and I love arcade games. I love playing video games with my friends, and then always playing games, even with my family, like board games and things like that. We do that from time to time, and then just having movie nights. That's probably the best thing right there, is the movie nights.
Nice, nice. And then if a GM walked in this room right now and said, "Why should I draft you? Give me the pitch," what would you be telling them?
Well, I'd start off with, I'm a mature 25-year-old. I've been through it all. I can be anything that you need me to be. I can be the hype guy. I can be the leader on the team. I can be somebody that is just going out there and playing their role. And I think that's where I fit in the best, is I can bring a whole bunch of guys together. I talk a lot. I make friends really easy, and I'm just a vocal person. So honestly, I can do just a little bit of everything. I think I'm a smart player, so that's something that I would tell them.
Awesome. Thanks, man. Good
Thank
luck.
You.
Yeah, appreciate it. That was great stuff.